How you doing, sir?
This your son?
Yes, sir.
Can I ask you why you're here? Can you ask me why you're here?
Thank you.
Logan, how are you here? Are your daddy telling you to be out here? Why are you here?
Because
this is your dad.
Yep.
What's your name?
I'm Todd Bullis. What's your name?
Jimmy Knight, Todd.
How you doing, sir?
Hey, I've been a member here for 5 years.
Uh-huh.
Explain to me why you're here.
Well, we're here because child sacrifice is the number one cause of death. And this church, your pastors and your elders, even though they have a good moral opinion, do nothing to help make it illegal.
How do you know that for sure?
Well, I know people that go here, all right? I have friends that go here, all right? And I know when a bill comes up to actually make it illegal, they do nothing to it. They do nothing to support it. No, it's true.
No, all this right. is Todd, listen.
Uh-huh.
I come in here day in and day out for 5 years. And it's not about my morals. It is about morals, but it's not about our moral thinking. It's the foundation of our church. That our church truly believes in exactly what you guys want to speak about. But it disappoints me here that you're speaking about non-truth and telling me about our pastor. Well, needs to repent.
He doesn't need to repent.
Listen, do you realize the fact, have you ever sat down and had a heart-to-heart conversation about his belief?
I know his beliefs are right, but the actions aren't happening.
Okay. If you have a one-on-one conversation or ever hear him preach about abortion and babies, just because the church or maybe he doesn't give to a certain foundation or a certain giving of money or this or that, exactly what you're saying that he doesn't believe. He believes in abortion. He doesn't believe in abortion.
So you're saying when HB 948 came up, he rallied the men.
He doesn't rally.
Right. Why not?
Well, because again,
if it was legal to kill bald people like me and you,
he still wouldn't be out there.
And he would preach against it, but he wouldn't try to make it illegal to kill bald people?
No. What I'm saying is he has ministries that go out there and do that. He has classes that go out there and teach on that. But our church, there's times, just like we go down every Sunday and every Saturday morning, we go to the foundation of downtown Dallas and give to the homeless and support the homeless.
Right. I know you do a lot of good things. I know.
But what's disappointing for me, and I wanted to just approach you as man to man, and you're having your children believe.
Right.
You're telling your children basically the foundation of our church or our pastor, because again, Pastor Chuck is the foundation of the belief of our church.
That's such bull.
It isn't though.
No, Christ is the foundation.
He is, but again,
not Chuck.
No,
not worship leader Chuck.
Exactly right.
You know?
But again, he preaches on the foundation of Scripture.
Okay, look.
So he brings and teaches.
Look. If the number one cause of death in our society is child sacrifice, and it goes unopposed, all right, that says a lot about the state of the church in Texas, right?
But there's a specific ones,
yes.
But not the foundation of a lot of churches.
I'm not saying Jesus Christ is bad. What I'm saying is we're not acting like Christians. We are not.
But
because we would oppose
it. But again, you're saying that about our pastor.
And yeah,
again,
I am saying it about your
pastor. The
pastor
is the foundation as he preaches the gospel.
He is not. He is not. Jesus Christ is.
You're still missing the mark.
He
is.
Look, he is a man just like you.
And what is he?
And just like me.
He teaches the Holy Scripture.
But he is not the foundation. He is not a foundation.
No, what I'm saying.
Jesus Christ is the foundation.
Exactly. And what does Pastor Chuck preach on? We preach on the foundation of Jesus Christ and the pillars of our church.
And the number one cause of death because of their inaction. In other words, having a correct moral opinion but not taking any correct moral action, child sacrifice is legal.
How do you know he's not doing that?
Because when those bills come up, he doesn't show up. He doesn't send people. There's not a message from the pulpit. There's nothing. Nothing. When there's a chance to make it illegal, he falls dead silent.
No,
when people tell him about... No, it's true.
Look at who
I have friends that sit there with the elders and talk to them, and they don't want to do anything.
Listen to who he's connected with, though, Todd. He's connected to people that sit, that people that go, that people that spread to, whether it's Washington, D.C., whether it's through
the foundation. More liable and more guilty.
No, he's not.
Yes, he is.
No, if he wasn't supporting any of the abortion, then it's a different story. But the foundation of our church.
John MacArthur, Chuck Swindoll, all these guys need to actually stand up and make stand to make it illegal. Not
they do,
just
Todd,
speak.
Go listen to them.
I have listened to them. I have listened to them.
Go do research and a study on them.
Have you seen this?
No, I don't need to see all that stuff.
Well, would you please look at it? Would you please look at it? Just because it talks about how we can make it illegal.
But listen. Even in Scripture, we'll never make that illegal. Because you know what?
We are supposed to subdue the land.
We do.
Okay?
And we're not. Abortion. We are against abortion.
How are you against it? That's just a phrase you say.
No, it's not.
Yeah.
Why?
If a woman was getting raped right there, how would you be against it?
The creation of life is from only him above. I can't take life.
Right.
I can't go and take life. But again, if a doctor goes and says, hey, I can take life, I can't go to that doctor and say, yeah, I'm gonna shut down your business because you can't do that. I can't do that. All I can do is say, hey, here's the reason.
Our government, who's supposed to dispense justice, does that. And what does our government do?
ISIS. What does our government do with all these other things? The government is the government.
This isn't about ISIS. This is about what we permit as men in our community.
Our church, but again, you're saying that our pastor doesn't believe in
anything. I'm saying you're guilty. What do you do?
I'm not guilty.
You are guilty. What do you do to help make it illegal?
What do I do when I go to, when I come across and the Lord brings somebody in my pathway, Todd?
Yeah.
Whether it's a male that has got his girlfriend pregnant or a female, I go and share if they're thinking about it or considering having an abortion. I share the gospel.
Witness to them.
I witness to them. Absolutely.
Right.
Again, and this is the foundation of our church, and Pastor Chuck's the same way. We witness to those people.
Right.
We have abortion clinics.
Right.
We have people that we support and we witness to and we share the gospel.
So if it was legal to own black people, would we just preach from the pulpit and talk to people? Or would we actually go and make abortion or make slavery illegal?
All you do is witness and support.
That's
the
not true.
It is. You can't go to the government and take.
Why can't you go to the government? The government's us.
No, the government isn't in D.C. who states the statutes of law. We can't go to the
Supreme Court is not our king.
Okay,
here in Texas, we can make our own laws.
So then why don't you go to Washington, D.C., stand in front of President Trump and all the White House people and tell them what you're telling us here? That's where
we,
you need
we
to
do.
Go.
We
that's
do.
The foundation
we do those types of things
the
all the time.
Where our church is built on
repentance. Repentance starts at the house of the Lord.
I appreciate you being a little more.
Okay.
You know,
well, would you look at this? So, just look. All you have to do is look.
I don't need to look at that. Listen.
Yes, you do.
I'm just saying, Todd.
I know what you're saying.
No, listen. You're condemning.
You worship Chuck Swindoll in this church. Yeah, you do. You already said he's your cornerstone. You said it multiple times.
He's the cornerstone because he preaches on the pillars and the foundation.
He's not the cornerstone.
Listen,
there's no reason why he's the cornerstone.
Todd, you're missing what I'm saying.
No, I hear what you're saying. I see your worship.
No,
I see your worship.
No,
I see your. I
listen to John MacArthur. I listen to Pastor Chuck. I listen.
Are they your cornerstones too?
No, Jesus Christ is my cornerstone.
Well, it's nice to hear you say that.
And I've been saying it all along.
No, you haven't.
Yes,
I have. No, you haven't.
The pillar stone, though, is
again. You won't take one of these. You don't want to open your eyes and see what we can do to make it illegal.
You just want to
get your ears tickled and be a pew warmer. And you just want to be a man that allows child sacrifice in the land and do nothing to make it illegal.
That's not
true. That is totally true. You've already told me you do nothing. You do nothing to help make it illegal.
I do lots, Todd. Listen, I just told you.
Well, then just look at this. Is it going to hurt you to look at this?
Well, what you're doing
why
is
won't
you're
you look at it? Why won't you look
church.
At it? Why won't you look at it?
Why?
I am. I'm condemning all of Christendom who's being apathetic.
You're condemning our pastor, and you don't even know the pillars of what he preaches on at the pulpit every Sunday. You don't know that.
No, he preaches well. He's a good preacher.
No, you just
preach.
He
he's a speaker. He's a speaker.
No, he's not.
Yeah.
No, he doesn't.
Yeah.
He brings
speaker.
The Holy Scripture truth. And is an expository.
Then why
teacher.
Aren't we opposing child sacrifice in the land? You
maybe
don't.
Not the way you want us to do it.
Well, how do you do it?
Maybe not the way. Listen, maybe not the way you want us to
will
do
you
it.
You just look at this.
No, Todd, I appreciate. Okay. It. Hey, listen, nice talking to you.
No, I don't want to shake your hand, man. Like I shake your hand.
Why
you're
not?
Being because
no,
you're being
no,
ungracious
not.
By not
no.
taking the literature.
I don't need it.
All right,
the
fine.
Literature.
Then why do you want to shake my hand?
Because you know what?
Why do you want to shake
again,
my hand?
I want you to know that. Hey, listen. We love you.
How do you love me?
We love you. And appreciate what
how
you're doing
do you
here
love
as far
me?
As this.
How do you love
but
me?
You're standing at the wrong. You're standing at
how
the wrong
do you
corner.
Love me?
Go to the corners.
You don't love
of
me.
Our foundation.
You don't
go
love me. You won't even listen to what I'm saying.
I do. I hear you every Sunday when I come through.
Okay. Well, I guess you're gonna hear me a few more.
Well, that's all right.
Okay.
You know, and
okay.
And,
it just takes me longer to get the message across.
No,
if you won't look at it.
No, I don't need to see that.
Okay.
I need the message.
Okay. All right.
But it's not appreciated that you say that against our pastor. That's all I wanted you to say.
I know. You protect your pastor. Worship your pastor.
Dad.
Yeah. Hold on. Hold on. Number one cause of death in Texas is child sacrifice. And men like this guy in the blue shirt, he worships the church building, his country club, his place where he can fill community. Meanwhile, children will be sacrificed, ripped from limb to limb, and he'll do nothing to oppose it. Nothing to stand up against it. How wicked and evil are men who sit in the pews on Sunday and listen every Sunday to a man they worship
and ignore child sacrifice and do nothing to make it illegal. Stonebriar Church, you need to repent of your apathy towards the young, the innocent. You need to repent of worshiping your $68 million a year budget. $68 million a year this church makes. It is time to repent and be obedient to the Word of God. Stop being pro-life and actually start acting like Christians.
There's again what I'm just saying right there. Now, you don't know me.
Right.
And you just said to your kids, and you said to the people outside that can hear this, you just said I'm a country club, whatever you call me. I'm not a country club. You know what?
I think you're a wicked and evil man.
I think you're a wicked and evil truck driver, blue-collar guy. I grew up in the country on a farmland. You know what?
So what?
So to say that because I dress like this, that I'm a country club guy, that is a lie, and you're telling your kids.
No, because you're walking into a $68 million a year country club. That's what you're doing.
It's a country club. It's a
church. It is. I think you're a wicked and evil man. That's what I think.
I'm not a country club guy, babe.
Listen,
I'm not.
This is what country clubs look like now.
Do you know where I live?
It doesn't matter.
You did, because you just said.
It doesn't matter where you live. You're going into your country club.
There goes that guy in the blue.
Right.
He's a country club.
Right.
I'm not a country
club.
You're
going to your country
club. I'm a blue-collar guy.
Why don't you go to your...
These are things that I wish you wouldn't lie about.
Get your ear... You're going to your country club.
It's a church. It's not a country club.
No, it's a country club.
Don't say it's a country club.
$68 million a year.
On the golf course. That's a church.
Look, there's your golf course.
Where's the golf course?
Look at that.
Where's the holes at, Tom?
Look at all the acres here. You know?
What you're saying is, where's the golf course?
It is. This is a modern-day country club.
To your eyes, and you're telling your kids this.
And to these children.
Don't say that I am a country club guy.
No, I can do more than that. I can say you're an evil and wicked man. How's that?
You can say that all you want.
Right. But the country club is what bothers you?
No. Yeah, exactly, because that's a lie.
No, you are.
Don't spread lies.
Go sit in your beautiful pews.
No, the point is, don't spread lies. If it was truth and you saw me on the country club, and you saw me get shelling out money to a country club, then you could say, there's that guy in the blue. He's a country club. He belongs to this country club.
That's what you do.
But that's not me.
That's what
I
you do.
I belong to my church.
This is a corporation. This is a corporation. It's not a church. You know what a church is? It's you and me. It's Christians. All right? It's not a 501c3. Which you're going to do right now is you're going to corporate worship, by the way, at your corporation. That's $68 million a year corporation.